Greetings, everyone, and welcome back. In the previous video, we imported all of our assets, and we took a moment to talk a little bit about skeletons and how they're used inside Unreal Engine 4. In this video, before we start working with our assets, wanted to kind of give you a quick crash course introduction to Persona, which is Unreal's animation editor, and it's actually much more than that. So let's take a moment to kind of run through the bells and whistles of Persona. And there's a couple of different ways that you can access Persona. Probably the most common is just by opening up specific assets inside the content browser. So if I go over to the Filters tab here really quickly and click on it, and under Animation, opening up any of these type of assets inside the content browser will open the Persona editor. So we have our skeleton and skeletal mesh that we created, and then any kind of animations, animation sequences, which are our animations here. Opening up any of these will open Persona. So let's actually open up Persona. I'm going to double click and open the third person idle, but you can open any animation you want for this video. So when I double click and open that up, we are now looking at Persona. And more specifically, we are looking at the animation tab of Persona. As you can see, there are three tabs. Currently, we are on the animation tab of Persona. This is where we're going to be doing all of our modifications to any animations. If I click the mesh tab is where we can define any kind of mesh details, where we can assign materials and change LOD settings, apply cloth settings, or any kind of other settings that we want to apply to our mesh. And looking at our mesh, it looks like he has a dislocated left arm here. I just noticed that, but we'll fix that in a later video if you're seeing that as well. You can also adjust morph targets, which our character doesn't have any, but if you had some, this is where you would do that in the mesh tab of the Persona editor. And then finally, we have the skeleton tab. This lists our skeleton, and it has all of our bone names and hierarchy here, hierarchy data. So we can see that here. And this is also where you can be doing any of your retargeting, is where you would do that inside the skeleton tab as well, as I mentioned in the previous video. So let's take a second really quickly to run through each of the windows on each of these tabs and kind of give you an example of what they do. So along the top here, we have the toolbar, which is pretty standard. It's probably not going to come into too much effect until we get into animation blueprints. And before I forget, I should mention that there will actually be a fourth tab up here, and that only comes into play when you open an animation blueprint. So you'll see that in a later video. So I just wanted to mention that really quickly. But back to the skeleton tab here inside Persona. The skeleton tree is very useful for probably adding sockets is probably the most common thing that you'll do inside the skeleton tree here. So for example, if I go to the left hand here and I click on it, you can see it's highlighted in the viewport now. I can actually right click on this and I can add a socket. And what that would allow me to do is I can now place something inside this socket through blueprint script. So a weapon or a sword or anything I want the character to carry, I can put inside this socket. And you can see in the details panel has now been populated with information about that socket, such as the name that I would need to reference, the location, etc. But inside the viewport here, I'm currently in rotation mode. If I hit W, I can actually move this socket anywhere I want. So if I wanted to get it really precise inside his hand, I can put it inside his hand there like so. Now the viewport, I'm actually using WASD to fly around. Very similar to the level editor viewport. I can press F to frame up on my selected object. I'm currently selected to the socket here, so it's selecting that. If I choose the skeleton and I press F, I'm framing up there. I can also hold Alt and left drag to kind of rotate around. Let me actually delete that socket because it's getting in my way and we're not going to use that. So let me delete that really quickly. So if I hold F, I can frame up on our character here and hold Alt to kind of rotate around him now, get kind of a 360 degree view of him. And I can also, as I mentioned, ASWD to kind of fly around as well. There's some other things inside the viewport here that I'll cover really quickly. We got the timeline here at the bottom. It's going to be on all the tabs, I believe. Yeah, it is. All the tabs have that timeline. And it's currently playing, just looping our animation that we've selected, the idle animation that is selected. We can pause that. We can reverse it, and fast forward and to the end, etc. Or set it to looping or not looping. Pretty straightforward. Along the top here, we have some options. We have, starting from the upper left here, if I click this drop down, then we have the preview mode. We can, as the tooltip says, preview what is active on the current window, lock the current window, camera follow, follow the bound of the mesh. Some of these settings, to be honest, you may not be using. But depending on your situation, you can come in here and change the background if you wanted to. There's also the perspective, similar to the level editor. We can change to a top view or front, etc. Most of the time, you're going to be in perspective mode. Then we have the view mode. You can set it to lit by default or unlit, or you can go into wireframe and a bunch of different options here as well. The show option has a bunch of different options for information purposes, probably. You could view any sockets that you have, probably bones, if you want to see the bones of your character. The bone names, you can see those as well, because that's kind of useful. Currently, we're displaying some information. We could actually turn that off if we want under display info here. So if I go down to display info, it's currently showing basic information. We could turn that off, so you don't need that. Then there's settings for LODs and so forth, playback speed of animation. A lot of this stuff we're just going to leave as default because we're not going to be touching it. And then along the right, we have the same options that are presented in the level viewport, which is the tools for switching between translation, rotation and scale, grid snapping, rotation snapping, camera speed, etc. So it's all pretty straightforward. Let's actually hop over to the mesh tab really quickly and talk about it. As I mentioned, this is where you do any kind of modifications to the skeletal mesh itself, like defining the materials for it, the LOD settings, applying clothing or apex clothing, or any additional information for the skeletal mesh. For the most part, we're going to be leaving this all default, but we will, in a future video, update the material so he has a little bit better material than this. And then we also have the morph target. I don't know if I mentioned this or not in the quick overview, but I'll do it again really quickly. This is where you're going to be adjusting any kind of morph targets if your character has them. Our character does not. We're not going to be doing that in this video series, but this is where you would come to do it inside the mesh tab of Persona. Then finally, we have the animation tab. This one's a little bit more heftier. There's the skeleton tree again, if you want to reference that. There's a details panel. It's currently not populated, but it will be populated once you start selecting different assets. Along the left here, we have the animation asset details. This is specific to the currently selected animation, which brings us to the asset browser here. And currently, we are looking at the idle animation, but we can double-click any animation, and it will start to play in the viewport, so we can see the run, we can see the walk, etc. And then in the center here, we are going to get to this a little bit later in the video series as well. We can add some notifies, curves, or tracks. Now, curves and tracks we're not going to be working with, but they are used elsewhere inside different editors inside Unreal. But they're very similar to the other implementations of those in other editors. For notifies, however, we are going to do that a little bit later. In the intro video, we showed how our character was running. And as he was running, he was creating a particle effect. So that is done with a notify. So really quickly, and again, this will have its own separate video. Essentially, what we could do is say at this point in the animation, we can right click in here and add a new notify. So we could play a footstep sound if we wanted to play a sound. We could play a particle effect, which we're doing later in this video series. We can add a new notify, which will give us a blueprint event that we could call off if we wanted to have some specific script fire off at any point in an animation by assigning that notify as well. So with that, I think that's where we're going to pause. We're about 9 minutes in. That gave us a quick introduction to Persona. In the next video, we're going to actually start working with our assets, I believe. No, actually, in the next video, we're going to set up our inputs. That'll be the first thing that we do. So that's pretty easy. So we'll go ahead and do that. We'll set up our inputs that we're going to be using. So that's going to wrap up this video. Again, this was just a quick introduction to Persona and the animation tab, the mesh tab, and the skeleton tab. And hopefully, we'll see you in the next video, and we'll start setting up our inputs. Thank you guys for tuning in.